Good morning. Happy Sunday. I'm Reverend Jennifer Cho, Senior Pastor here at Bridgewater United Methodist Church. I greet you all in the name of our Lord Savior Jesus Christ. May the peace of Christ be with you. Welcome to this online worship service. I'm so glad you're here and worship with us this morning. Today is the last Sunday of our sermon series, New Beginnings, and together we will learn that a new beginning is possible whenever you are ready. May God bless you abundantly as we sing, praise, pray, and listen for God's word for us. Now I'd like to invite you to join me in this call to worship as we worship our awesome God together. Read it responsibly. To worship and pray, we have come this day. To meditate on God's teachings, we have come this day. Gather as one family of Christ, we come together in love. Let us worship God together.
Good morning. I'm Jen Schaber, your Young Families Ministry Coordinator here at BUMC. Coming up on Sunday, May 23rd at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, we are going to have a really cool event called Service Sunday. We are going to pack meals for ship, and we are also going to collect books and help refill the little free libraries that are in town. We will have the event hopefully outdoors. If not, we will move inside, but we would love to have you. If you could RSVP by May 20th to the email address below, that would be great. We would love to have you guys there.
Friends, this month, May, is the Mental Health Awareness Month. Each year, millions of Americans face the reality of living with a mental illness. So we joined a national movement to raise awareness about mental health and educate the public about mental illnesses and suicide. Now more than ever, especially during this pandemic, we need to find ways to stay connected with our community. No one should feel alone or without the information, support, and help they need. You are not alone. Please check the information on the screen. National Suicide Prevention Hotline at 800-273-8255. NAMI. Their website is www.nami.org. Do not wait and contact them and get help right away. If you need pastoral care, contact Reverend June Tambora or myself. We want to pray for you and your loved ones. Thank you.
Good morning, friends. I'm Reverend June Tambora, the Associate Pastor here at the Bridgewater United Methodist Church, and it's good to be with you this morning. This is the time in our worship when we join our hearts together before God in a spirit of prayer. So will you join me now before our living God? Holy One, out of the bleak winter, you have brought new life to the natural world that surrounds us. We join our voices together today with all of nature and sing of your creative power and offer you our praise. Help us to recognize in the signs of spring your promise to restore and renew us, even during our times of deathly darkness. Create in us new and transformed hearts that overflow with your goodness and love, and prepare us for all the new beginnings you have in store for our lives. God of mercy, we approach your throne of grace today and lay bare all the ways that we have failed you this past week. For all that we have done or left undone that displeases you, forgive us. Guide us like a gentle shepherd back to the path that leads to life. And as we accept your transforming forgiveness, help us to forgive others who have hurt or harmed us. Send us the blessed assurance that no matter what mistakes we make, we are your beloved, perfectly created in your image. Fix our eyes on Jesus and help us to accept the love that he came to share so that we too might be your agents of light and love in a hurting world. Great physician, we entrust to your care friends and loved ones who stand in need of your healing touch today, whether in mind, body, or spirit. And we continue to pray for the people of India as they suffer the trauma and grief of the coronavirus running out of control. Our hearts ache for them and their loved ones. Show us how to offer mercy even from across the miles. Teach us, Lord, that when one of your precious children suffers anywhere, all of creation suffers everywhere. And let this be our call to work for justice in all places and for all people. Spirit of gentleness, we give you thanks for your abiding presence and for knowing our needs before we even ask. With joy and gratitude in our hearts, we offer you now in one voice the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you. Please join me in this prayer of dedication. Bless these gifts to be nourishment for a world hungry for your grace. Bless us to be nurturers of love for a world hungry for your compassion. Bless us to be one in ministry with you and with one another. Through the power of your Holy Spirit. Amen. Today's scripture reading is from Revelations chapter 3, verses 7 through 13. And to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, "These are the words of the Holy One, the true One, who has the key of David, who opens and no one will shut, who shuts and no one opens. I know your works. Look, I have set before you an open door, which no one is able to shut. I know that you have but little power, and yet you have kept my word and have not denied my name. Because you have kept my word of patient endurance, I will keep you from the hour of trial that is coming on the whole world to test the inhabitants of the earth. I am coming soon. Hold fast to what you have, so that no one may seize your crown. If you conquer, I will make you a pillar in the temple of my God. You will never go out of it. I will write on you the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, the New Jerusalem that comes down from my God out of heaven, and my own new name. Let anyone who has an ear listen to what the Spirit is saying to the churches. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God."
Good morning, friends. Over the past 2 weeks, we reflected on the theme of new beginnings and learned how to remember and how to forget essential elements of our faith in the process of beginning again. Today, we will learn together, and there can be a new beginning in your life whenever you are ready. So won't you pray with me? Our God of new beginnings, who makes all things new by your grace, we come before you as your humble and faithful servants, and we invite you into our conversation with open spirits, open hearts, and open minds. Guide and bless our time according to your good purpose. In your holy name we pray. Amen. Today's scripture is from the book of Revelation, chapter 3, which records Jesus' message to the sixth of seven churches addresses in Revelation chapter 2 and 3. The Philadelphia church is the recipient of this letter. In this passage, Jesus blessed them with his affirmations and promises. Well, this is such a rich text, and let me just summarize four of Jesus' messages. First, Jesus affirms the church's positive actions. He says, "I know your works. Look, I have set before you an open door that no one is able to shut. I know that you have but little power, and yet you have kept my word and have not denied my name." Jesus then condemns the enemies of the Philadelphian believers, and he says, "I will make them come and bow down at your feet, and they will learn that I have loved you." Jesus also encourages them regarding his future coming. "Because you have kept my word of patient endurance, I will keep you from the hour of trial that is coming on the whole world to test the inhabitants of the earth. I am coming soon. Hold on to what you have so that no one may seize your crown." Then Jesus provides a final promise to the believers in Philadelphia and to all believers. He says, "If you conquer, I will make you a pillar in the temple of my God. You will never go out of it. I will write on you the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, the New Jerusalem that comes down from my God out of heaven, and my own new name." In other words, those who struggle with the little power or weakness, Jesus makes them everlasting pillars in the house of God. The Church of Philadelphia was weak in some respects, yet they had remained faithful in the face of trial. Because of this, Jesus promises them an open door of blessing. Open door of blessing. So let's talk about that. The open door. As you may remember, our United Methodist Church was known as the People of United Methodist Church with open hearts, open mind, and open door. The open door is a powerful symbol to anyone who is ready to leave a troubled past and launch out on a new beginning. One of the great I Am proclamations of Jesus is, I am the door. The symbol of the door held open by irresistible divine power is more encouraging to a wonderful soul looking for a way to begin again than a symbol of Christ standing out the door knocking, awaiting the initiative of someone who is inside. Revelation chapter 3 verse 20 says, "Listen, I am standing at the door knocking. If you hear my voice and open the door, I will come into you and eat with you and you with me." The door held open by divine power suggests that God in Christ has already acted in our behalf. We do not have to open the door. We only need to walk through it. We call it as God's grace and God's generosity. You may recall my first sermon on Remember. I mentioned the name of Janus, Roman God. The symbol of Janus reminds any thoughtful person to consider a new beginning for some aspects of life. It is a timely reminder. The open door in Revelation is not an annual proposition. The open door is an anytime proposition. There can be a new beginning in your life whenever you are ready. And there are many things that make us conscious of the need and the opportunity to make a new beginning. When someone we love dies, life is never the same again. The death of the spouse or child or parent or any significant other or even pet so radically reshapes relationships and feelings that a new beginning is essential. After allowing time for the shock of wear off and the grieving process to run its course, there comes a distinct time to gather up the loose ends and begin again without the presence of someone who was once so central to life. Any significant loss is in some sense like a death and requires a period of grief and readjustment before beginning again. Eric Hoffer, longshoreman turned philosopher, reminded us that a person's heart is a grave long before that person is buried. Something in us dies when we lose anything great or small. All losses requires a reassessment of life to accommodate that loss. We have all witnessed essential new beginnings in our lifetime. In the wake of ends such as divorce, relocation, career change, and so on. While these new beginnings may well produce healthier lives later, the pain of the moment can be great. Those who go through the experience welcome the powerful hand of God holding the door open for us. Every pastor witnesses new beginnings in persons who have lost their jobs or who have suffered significant financial setbacks. Beginning again is not easy, but it is possible and necessary. There are new beginnings that may well bring joy in the morning, but they are preceded by a long, dark night of suffering and sorrow. You have probably witnessed an alcoholic or drug addict making a new beginning. You may have had that experience yourself. It is a terrible experience any time of the year, but when you are ready, it is possible. When all your strength and willpower is gone, and God will send someone to hold the door open. Not all new beginnings are successful in the first try. Some find it necessary to begin again several times before making it safely through the open door. Do not become discouraged if you have to begin again, again, and again until you make it. We all fantasize that starting over again can be done with one big effort, that the process will never have to repeat it. Well, that is a wonderful thought, but more often than you might think, old habits and old patterns of defeat tend to return. They slip up on your backslide. They return in disguise and have you in their clutches before you realize what is happening. But do not despair, my friend. Any new beginning that is worth our time and effort is worth doing again. The door does not close when you fail. There is a sense in which a life-changing, God-directed, new beginning never ends. Abraham's story in the Bible. The life and times of the patriarch Abraham is a good example of how an important new beginning takes a lifetime and more. There's a passage in the New Testament book of Hebrew that summarizes the long story of Abraham's new beginning. By faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to set out for a place that he was received as an inheritance, and he set out not knowing where he was going. By faith, he stayed for a time in the land he had been promised, as in a foreign land, living in tents, as did Isaac and Jacob, who were heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked forward to the city that has foundations, whose architect and builder is God. After answering God's call, Abraham never had a dwelling place more permanent than a tent. He left his home in Haran, not knowing where he was going, and spent the rest of his life without ever reaching a permanent destination. He was a wayfaring pilgrim whose new beginning never ended. There never was a time in which Abram was not reshuffling the circumstances of his life and the life of his family in order to follow the call of God to a destination beyond the parameters of this world. Abraham was forever beginning. His life was a journey, not a destination. And so is my life and yours. Friends, let us make the changes and adjustments imposed on us by circumstances or changes chosen because we see a better way. These are new beginnings that can be made whenever we are ready. It doesn't have to be the beginning of each year or on our birthday. It can be any time we realize we are not moving in the right direction. It can be any time we don't like the way we are and we see how we can be different. Just don't forget the big new beginning that lasts a lifetime. It is our journey in faith to a destination about which we have only faint knowledge. Only God knows. All changes and adjustments of what we think, say, and do are to be made with deferences to the large purpose and call about which we must trust more than we know. Apostle Paul says it best, "Not that I have already obtained this or have already reached the goal, but I press on to make it my own, because Christ Jesus has made me his own. Beloved, I do not consider that I have made it my own, but this one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead, I press on toward the goal for the prize of the heavenly call of God in Christ Jesus." Friends, just remember the big picture and make changes that are respectful of the big picture. You can do that anytime, whenever you are ready. God has given us the open door, Jesus, for our salvation and dynamic life of discipleship. We just need to make a simple decision to walk right through it whenever we are ready, even now. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Thank you.
Friends, I'm so glad that you joined and worship with us this morning. Next Sunday is Pentecost, which is the festival when Christians celebrate the gift of the Holy Spirit. As you know, Pentecost is the birthday of Christian Church and the start of the Church's mission to the world. So let's celebrate the birthday of the Church together, and I will preach my sermon when the Spirit comes. Please join our outdoor service at 9 a.m. an online service at 10 a.m. With the spirit of Pentecost, I encourage you to wear a red shirt if you plan to attend outdoor service at 9 a.m. I hope I can see you there. Friends, until we meet again, let us keep one another in our prayers and thoughts. Have a wonderful and blessed week. Now, please join me in this responsive benediction. With the power of God's Holy Spirit, we have been made one in unity and love. Even as we go our separate ways, we go in unity and love. We go to serve and love with the power of the Spirit. We go with the blessing of the community, guiding our steps and protecting our path. Go in peace. Amen.